Sometimes there are things that we need and don't even know about. Have a look at this. Do you know what it's for? We call it GPeR, which stands for Gigabit Passive Ethernet Repeater. It was designed to extend the range of your Ethernet cables when you need to cover more than a couple hundred meters. In fact, if you use several of these, your Ethernet connection could be stretched out close to a mile long or about 1,500 meters. Now, that makes these a tempting alternative to optical solutions such as GPON, hence the play on words in the naming. But I bet you prefer to play with technology, and this is a cool one. It doesn't work like an analog signal amplifier such as with audio or radio. Instead, it has a switch chip inside that is forwarding the data. You could almost say that it is a little switch with two 1 gigabit ports. One is labeled PoE in and the other is PoE out. That is how it powers itself and how it is possible to do a chain of these without having to worry about power sockets along the way. Despite the labeling, the ports are functionally symmetrical. There are jumpers at both ends and removing them will prevent the PoE functionality at that end. The minimum input voltage is 24 volts and that is what would be necessary to power this device and run another 210 meters of Ethernet after it, with power injected. In practice, the 24 volts is not a hard limit, it is possible to go below it, especially on the last GPeR on your cable. If you remove the jumpers at the PoE out end, it could help a little. And you should be removing those jumpers on the last unit anyway, because unless you're trying to power some small device at the other end, you don't want to be injecting power where it is not needed. An important powering consideration that I would like to stress is the natural power loss in direct current cables. If you run 100 meters of cable with 24 volts going in one end, it will no longer be 24 volts coming out the other end. The longer the cable, the bigger the losses will be. So, if you're going to do a chain of multiple GPeRs, I highly recommend starting with the highest voltage available to you. The maximum you can feed these is 57 volts. And when you are starting that high, you could chain link up to 7 of these, reaching as far as 1.5 kilometers in distance. However, you can go mad scientist here and double those numbers with 14 GPeRs and 3 kilometers in distance. If you run power from both ends and just disable PoE on the very middle link. Now, I'm saying mad scientist because RJ45 connections are not impeccable. Issues can occur and then you have a lot of potential points of failure to check. So, I wouldn't recommend doing 14 of these in a row, but it is a cool fact that you could if you had to. Finally, when it comes to running long distances of cable, you have to be wary of dust and humidity. The GPeR is rated for indoor use only, but we offer an outdoor enclosure, the GPeR IP67 case. As the name suggests, it was aimed at an IP67 rating, but it ended up passing all the tests for IP68, so technically you could run your Ethernet underwater. I don't care what the weatherman says, when the weatherman says it's raining, you'll never hear me complaining. I'm certain the sun will shine. I don't care how the weather vane points, when the weather vane points to gloomy, it's gotta be sunny to me.